Hi friends, I welcome you all to a new lecture today. Today we are going to discuss about the earliest civilization on Indian subcontinent, that is the Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization. It got its name from the city of Harappa, which was the first city to be excavated from this period. So let's start with the extent to which this civilization was spread. We'll look at the major sites or cities in the civilization. So this is the map, and if we observe this map carefully, we'll find that the major settlements of this period were around the banks of River Indus. Let me show you. So this was the River Indus, and the major settlements are found in this area. But as new discoveries unfold, we found that the extent of Indus Valley civilization was much more, and we will look at that. It was in Sutka Gendor in far west Pakistan, near the border of Iran, to Alamgirpur in Uttar Pradesh. So it is far from River Indus in Uttar Pradesh, and in Daimabad in Maharashtra is the southernmost city discovered till now, and Manda in Jammu and Kashmir. So the earliest assumptions that the Indus Valley civilization was around River Indus was proved to be false. The other major cities in these areas are Harappa, which is the first city to be excavated in 1921. A year later, city of Mohenjo-daro was discovered. And now we are familiar with more than 1000 sites today, and that too spread in a vast area of in northwest part of Indian subcontinent. So if we see that the major, if we see, locate the major cities, I have already told you that it is the westernmost city called Sutka Gendor in Pakistan, Dholavira, Lothal in Gujarat area. Dholavira is the most recent site discovered today. Nageshwar and Balakot were the centers for making shell art. Chanhodaro was one site which was completely dedicated to craft production. Banavali and Rakhegiri in Haryana, Kalibangan in Rajasthan, and Manda in Jammu and Kashmir. So we are going to read one by one these important cities now. So we'll first start with the city of Harappa, which is today is part of Pakistan area. It was the first site to be excavated in 1921 by John Marshall. He was the head of ASI, Archaeological Survey of India, at that time. And the Harappan civilization got the name from this city only. It was on the bank of River Ravi. As you can see, it is on the bank of River Ravi, the city of Harappa. And the major archaeological findings from this city is a coffin burial, which tells us about that how the are there any social differences among the people in Indus Valley, or what was the lifestyle of these people, what were their religious beliefs, if any, or many other things from which the archaeologists try to recreate the and learn about these people. There was a red sandstone male torso which was found from this site, which tells us that there was sculpture making art which these people were profound at, and they used to use red sandstone for that. The other major site is Mohenjo-daro, which is also part of Pakistan now. It is the largest excavated town of the civilization. You have to remember here that the largest town is Rakhigarhi, which is in Haryana, but it is not excavated till now, and the largest site is Mohenjo-daro. It is present on the bank of river Indus. As you can see here, Mohenjo-daro is present on the bank of river Indus. A unicorn seal has been found from this site. So, Indus Valley people used to write their language, which is not deciphered yet, on a seal, which used to contain a portrait of an animal which had one horn. But it is supposed that unicorn, which they called, is a mythological animal, and we really don't have any evidence that it was a real animal. There is a seal found having Pashupati Shiva, a man in a meditative posture has been found, and it has been named as Pashupati Shiva. The other great features in this site is Great Bath, which was a rectangular swimming pool, which has stairs in north and south direction, made up of bricks, and rooms on all three sides. We will discuss all these details in later videos. For now, we have to remember that Great Bath has been found or discovered in this site. And there was a palace, rectangular palace, which may be used as a political meeting hall. A warehouse has been found and granaries has been found. The next site is in Rajasthan, naming Kalibangan. It is on the bank of river Ghaggar. From here, evidence of plow agriculture is found, because as you can see in this picture, that furrow markings are there. These show that people of Indus Valley were familiar with the plow agriculture. And further, a plow terracotta toy is also discovered from one of the sites. I'll tell you in later. So what is this? That east to west, the furrow markings were dense, and from north to south direction, these were wider. So this could be because that they may be growing two crops in the same field, one being a leguminous crop. So they were aware about double cropping. And we know the reasons for double cropping, that it increases the fertility of the soil. The other major site is Dholavira in Gujarat state. It is the most recent excavated site and located on Khadir Bet, which is an island in Great Run of Kutch in Gujarat state. So Harappans were first to use writings in India. Most of the Harappan writings were on seal. Seals were made of soft stone, steatite, and most of the seal was square, on which various small writings and pictures of animals were found. From this site, we have discovered the biggest or the longest writing, which is the picture which you can see here. It was for city guides and was written on hard stone. The Harappan writings, unfortunately, The Harappan writings are still undeciphered, but most likely the language used in writing was Proto-Dravidian language. The other major city which we have to look in today is Lothal, which is also in Gujarat. Lothal is located on the top of Gulf of Khambat region in Gujarat, near the Sabarmati River and the Arabian Sea. And there was a canal which was built to transport the items of trade till the Arabian Sea. There was an artificial dockyard which has also been found, and most likely it was a trade center which was used to dock ships and a trade center to Mesopotamia, the contemporary civilization of Indus Valley civilization. There was evidence of rice which was found only in Lothal. Otherwise, the grains like wheat, bajra and jowar, these type of grains were found. The other city which is important for us is Surkotada in Gujarat. Animal bones which look like the bone of horse has been found from this site. On Harappan scenes, we usually discover the depiction of animals. The maximum time the picture of an animal depicted on Harappan seal is a unicorn, which was a mythological and not a real animal, and it was always facing towards right with a single horn and a three-story manger which looks like flame is placed below the writing. There are no evidence or no depiction of horse on Harappan seal. The other site is Rakhigari in Haryana, which I have already told you is the largest city of Harappan civilization, but it is not excavated till date. The next is Banavali in Haryana. As we know that Harappans used to practice flow agriculture, it was more confirmed by a terracotta toy which was found as an evidence of using plough for agriculture. It has been found from Banavali in Haryana. The next site is Chunhadaru. It was completely dedicated for craft production, including bead making, shell cutting, metal working, seal making and weight making. There were various materials used like carnelian, which was in red color stone, jasper, crystal, quartz and steatite. Metals were also used for craft production like copper, bronze, gold and other materials like shell, faience and terracotta. Terracotta toys were very popular among Indus Valley people. Here you can get a glance that how the beadwork and jewelry ornaments look like for the Indus people. So you can see that it is in various type of shapes. Some are disc shaped, some are cylindrical, spherical, barrel shaped or segmented and whatnot. So the next site which we will look today is Shortughai in Afghanistan. Here we got the evidence that they used to build canals for irrigation purposes. And this is a stone which is very attractive, and it had high value at that time also. It is called lapis lazuli, a blue stone. And they used to make products or craft from this stone and trade to Mesopotamia also. The next site are Nageshwar and Balakot. These are near the coast. So these were the coast cities, and these were specialized center for making shell bangles, which were there in abundance, obviously, because they were near the coast. These cities were near the coast. So these were the sites used to make shell bangles, ladles, and inlay. Ladles were like spoons and all that stuff. And these craft or these articles were also transported to bigger cities like Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, and further transported to Mesopotamia also. So I hope you enjoy watching this video, and have a great day ahead. Thank you so much.